Gunsmoke. And the action-packed drama of Gunsmoke.
Around Dodge City and in the territory out west, there's just one way to handle the killers and the spoilers. And that's with a state marshal and the smell of gun smoke. Gunsmoke is a story of the violence that moved west with young America. It's also my story. Me, Matt Morgan, U.S. Marshal. I'm the first man they look for and the last they want to meet. Then comes the time when you're not looking for anyone, but something happens that puts you in debt. I go across the slash town in Lost River. I'm on the way back to Dodge. Long rides on powerful tide. The Bronx galloping hard on account he can send prairie dogs somewhere. I do nothing to curb the blind gallop. I can think of only one thing. Get the Dodge. Maybe that's why neither my bronc nor I see whatever it is that trips us. All I can recollect is my bronc somersault and my hand shooting out to protect myself as the ground comes up, hits me in the face. I don't hear my bronc get to its feet gallop away, nor do I hear the reason why it gallops away. I guess I know nothing about the next 15 minutes or so. Those mangy prairie dogs gathered up mob courage and skittered on from nearby hills. Skitter right up close. Buzzard base? Well, here's me already from prairie dog base. Only I don't know it. I don't know what a couple of those coyotes are waking up to do. And that's like a snap of the throat, tear it out.
I fence, deep and stubborn coyotes been feasting themselves on that hombre. Come on, let's take a closer look. I keep still, you pesky mutt. Them coyotes cut the breeze right out of the territory by now. So keep still or by Lombard, I'll slap your snout. Yeah, that's better. Now let's take a look at this poor galoot. Still breathing. That's one thing. Well, let's roll him over and get a look. Squint at his throat. Coyotes kind of go for an obvious. Stay. You persist. Yeah, look, you want me, mutt? Keep still. Keep still, will you? Hold it. Now, I'll get the water bottle out of the saddlebag. Here should be somewhere. Put his head up on my. And the neck of this between his lips, and maybe he'll swallow some. Come on, fella. Get them lips open. Get some water into your insides. Come on, come on. Fine, we're doing fine. That's it. Now try a couple mouthfuls more.
No more. No more.
Hey, come on, plenty left. Yep. Them as marks and signs of prairie dogs.
Hey, they were all around
me. I know.
You saw them, the dogs?
Fella, I come riding along the trail around the bend, and what's the next thing I see? A bunch of dogs, a pack of coyotes sniffing and snarling all over here. They scatter when I throw lead in their particular direction. Don't get one, but when they scatter, I see they almost got what looks to be an hombre lying on the trail.
I guess words are pretty useless when it comes to trying to say thanks in a situation like this. I mean,
Oh, just forget it.
You saved my life.
I said forget it.
Mister, that's going to be impossible.
Look, just tell me two things. First, you figure you got any bones broke?
No, but I'm developing some mighty powerful bruises.
Well, no bones broke. That's good. Now, second thing, how comes the marshal of the law is found lying in the middle of the trail?
All I can recollect is my horse suddenly tripping, the head going down. Next thing, I guess the ground hits me in the face.
U.S. Marshal. He was heading which way?
Back to Dodge.
So? That makes you Marshal Morgan.
Right up to his hocks and you're dead.
Oh, look, I said forget it. And my name's Sweeney, Paul Sweeney. I run the AAA ranch a couple of miles out from where the trail forks.
Sweeney, this is one of the few times I can name these words. I'm mighty glad to know you.
Why, I'm pleased to make your acquaintance, Marshal. Now, reckon you can get to your feet?
Sure.
Take your time, take your time. Yeah. Get your arm around my shoulders.
Yeah.
Look, Paul, Old stallion, pass me mud, will you?
Now, just for your playing up, fella, you're going to carry double.
You figure your mount will do it, Sweeney?
Oh, you bet. Not that far now to my place. Rest up a while I send a couple of boys out and look for your bronc. If they don't find it, then help yourself to one of mine. All right?
You know, you're making me feel that maybe human nature's got something good in it after all.
Oh, I'm only doing what any honest citizen would do. Now, I'll hold the bronc still, and you see if you can fall clever, huh? Now, take your time, Marshal. Take your time.
Take my time. It's a tough proposition, but I finally fall clever. Sweeney rides in front, and just under an hour, we reach his place, the Triple A Ranch.
Hey, boss, what's going on? What's happened, huh?
There been what, Felky?
Trouble?
Why, ain't you never seen a marshal before? Why, I don't take no notice of him, Marshal Morgan. Felky's an old frontier, Annie, but plenty law-abiding. All right, Felky, give the marshal a hand down.
What?
Doesn't matter. I guess I can make the ground.
Just take it easy, Marshal. Felky, go get a couple of the boys, Buzz Concord and Yorker. Look for the marshal's bronc somewhere around the fork. What kind of Mustang they bring in?
A 5-all with a Winchester repeater holster at the saddle, the ride side of the saddle.
Sure. Get all, boss?
No, before you leave, go make some jabber.
Sure. Get. Yeah. Special jabber?
I want some, you fuzz-faced maverick. Go on, get to a condo.
I don't want to make sure it's not.
Why, this way, Marshal. In through.
Sweeney helps me into the main ranch house. Big, rambling place, timber and adobe. Like the rest of the spread, I can see it's in first-class order. Clean, pink flesh, nothing untidy. Overall, an air of prosperity. The hombre called Pelky shows up with a big pot of good coffee and some meats. When we finish them, I tell Sweeney what I think of the place.
Well, I guess the reason why we never meet before, Marshal, is that I don't move into this territory until a year back. I find this place falling apart, though. I buy it from the owner, Kim Bardu, who is itching to go back east a ways. He gets my money and vamooses. I work hard, and, well, guess you've seen the result.
Well, sure is a pleasure to see a ranch as good as this. Almost makes me wish I'd been a cattleman.
Yes. Well, it's never too late to start, you know.
Now, stick to the lower trail, I guess.
Every man to his own trail, I suppose. Let me get you some more java, Marshal. A couple of hours
died pleasantly, and Sweeney's boys returned with my bronc. Feeling 100 times better, I thank Sweeney for everything, and his men for locating the mount, and I brought back the Dodge. Week goes by, and I'm fully recovered. Getting around the city, making my usual checks on people and places. But there's one place I don't check tonight. That's the gambling saloon on the edge of the city, a dive with the name of the Black Garter. Now, usually, the Black Garter is pretty well behaving. Hard games, been as straight as any you'll find. Dancing gals work strictly to union rates, and the liquor served is no more rot foot than any other. That's why I'm a mite surprised when they tell me that an argument breaks out between two poker players. One shoots the other dead. The dead fella being Buzz Concord, and the one who exercises a smoke pole, Holt Sweeney. Next morning, I'm tethering the bronc to the hitching rail outside the law office, and I see a small group of grim-faced rannies coming my way. A leader I recognize, Willie Cumber, a fellow with considerable influence among the ranchers. Little posse marches right up, stops, and Willie Cumber steps forward.
Marshal, we got serious business with you.
Uh-huh.
Powerful serious.
You want me to talk out here, or we go inside my law office?
Yes, it don't matter any folk here, in it.
No.
On account of all us cattle folks know why I'm here and what I'm here to say. In fact, they make me their spokesman.
Go ahead, Comrade. You're the spokesman, all right. Spokesman about what?
A murdering cattle rustler.
A murdering cattle rustler? One operating in this territory?
One operating in this territory. You see, fellas, like all folks say, the marshals gonna plead ignorance.
Look, Comrade, I don't get your drift. What's this all about?
A murdering cattle rustler.
You said that.
And I'll go on saying it till you put a rope around his mangy neck and crack it.
Comlet, you claim you're a spokesman. Now, in my language, a spokesman's an hombre who explains things, too.
All right. If you're going to play it ignorant, then we're going to play it tough.
Tough?
Acting the ignorant parrot won't do you no good neither, Marshal.
Comlet, and the rest of you, don't get the idea I'm not watching your gun hands. Don't get the notion you're not waiting for the break to cut me down, because you are. All right. The gun smoke you want, make your break. Make your play.
Hold it, boys. Hold it. The marshal's only trying to gun thunder his way out of this. But he ain't fooling us none. You savvy that, Marshal? You ain't fooling us none.
10 seconds. That's all I'm allowing. 10 seconds. And if by that you haven't started to explain, Tumbler, and I'm tossing you all in a hooska.
Marshal Morgan, I am explaining. I'm explaining that unless you arrest and string up that no-good murdering cattle rustler, then me and all the rest of Dodge City folk, we're going to see that you get your marshal's badge ripped off and that you run out on a rail.
I figure your 10 seconds have gone, Tumbler.
Marshal, you got 10 hours to ride out and bring in your gun hawk pod. Or we get a new marshal. Savvy?
No.
All right. And if you don't go get him, I guess we form a posse and go get him ourselves. Only I can't guarantee the boys will bring him in. Not if they pass a nice, high cottonwood tree. One strong enough to take a hanging.
Who is this so-called murdering cattle rustler?
We gotta tell you, Marshal.
Name the name.
The Major Gunhawk who swindled Kimbardo out of his AAA spread. The sneaking gun cheat who plugged Buzz Concord outside the Black Garter. The no-good coyote who's building up a AAA on stolen beef, that's who.
Holt Sweeney?
Holt Sweeney. And we demand you go right out and kill him. If you don't, then I guess you're finished as a marshal. What's your answer, Morgan? Morgan, what's your answer?
What do you expect?
That you'll fix Holt Sweeney for a 6-foot piece of real estate, but not in our local boot hill. Fix it for him out in the prairie someplace. We reserve our boot hill for only decent killers and gunnies. Get it?
Look, Cumbler, let's take all this one thing at a time.
Ain't nothing to take, Morgan, except our word that if you don't get Sweeney, then we folk get him. And we get you.
Cumbler, you and the boys threatening to string me up?
Not you, Morgan. Only Sweeney.
Let's take things one at a time. Last night,
Buzz Concord steps out of the Black Garter and steps right into 3 slugs from Sweeney's gun.
Anyone see Sweeney shoot Concord?
They was playing cards together, and Concord cleans him out. Sweeney figures to equalize it by dry gulching Concord later.
You got it all wrong.
Morgan, Sweeney was sighted coming away from there right after the shooting, and nobody else was around.
Sir?
So Buzz Concord was a fast hombre with his guns. And when he was found lying there, dead on the sidewalk, his guns wasn't even out of their holsters. And savvy this, Morgan, Buzz Concord was faster than Holt Sweeney. He shot him without warning.
You're saying Sweeney murdered Concord?
Ain't saying, Morgan. Like all other folk, we're stating Sweeney murdered Concord. You know as well as we do that when an hombre kills another in a fair fight, giving him an even chance for the draw, then we overlook it. But we don't overlook murder.
You know, Cumber, if someone told me this was happening, that I was going to hear such loco words, I'd declare him crazy.
Ain't nothing crazy about a man getting killed unfair.
There's plenty crazy about you implying that I overlooked murder.
Well, maybe so, maybe not.
Cumber, I want proof before I arrest a man for murder.
To us, there's enough proof about last night. Just like there's enough proof that Sweeney's a rustler.
Sure as Hades hot, the day'll come with. All right, boys, you claim Sweeney's a rustler. Tell me how you figure that one out.
Simple. Sweeney cheats Kimbardo out of the AAA.
Kimbardo wasn't cheated out of the AAA. He was bought out of AAA on account he was mighty glad to vamoose back east, where that type of hombre's welcome, but not out here in the West.
Sweeney takes over. In a year, he builds up a powerful big herd of beef in that little time. From the amount of calves he's running, all his cows must have litters instead of one or two at a time.
Oh, so that's it. Because a man takes over a rundown place, builds it up, buys calves, turns a dead beef spread into a flourishing ranch in a year. You fellas reckon that makes him a rustler, huh?
10 hours, Morgan.
And what if I say no?
Then we elevate some other hombre to the office of marshal. so we can call a special election.
This is the office of a federal-appointed United States Marshal. It's not the office of a sheriff.
Morgan, you ever been ridden out of town on a rail?
Have you?
Sorry, huh?
Look, Cumler, I've let you have your say. Now I'm having mine.
10 hours, Morgan. All right, boys, let's go.
Cumler and the rest of you.
Change your mind, huh?
No.
Then there just ain't no sense in word-slinging no more. The citizens of this here place don't stand for any lawman, federal or not, who plays favorites.
What? I'm playing favorites?
We all know Sweeney done you a big favor. That's why you're letting him get away with rustling and now murder.
Sweeney saved my life.
So we hear tell. So that's how we figure the situation.
Get out, Cumler. Get out of my sight and take your hangdog, shuffling posse with you. Just get right out of my sight before I throw you all in the hoosegow for... Go on, cut the breeze out of my sight.
10 hours, Morgan.
I guess it takes all kinds of folk to help tame the West. Kinds that include young frontier rannies who are stubborn, bigoted, blind, and stupid. But honest and just according to their own rules. Right now, the rules of Cumler in this part are dangerous. Unless I can prove to these critters that they're riding the wrong trail where Sweeney's concerned. That's why I forked Leather out of Dodge mighty fast, head for the AAA. To me, there's only one way to handle a situation created by Cumler, and that's to show him and his pards how completely impossible are their accusations. It's a long and punishing ride out to AAA, but my bunk stands up to it. We make it without any accident. I find Sweeney talking with Pelkey near the main bunkhouse, and without any preliminaries, I ask him about his movements last night.
Well, now, let's see.
You lost the cards at Concord.
Why, sure, but not that much. Around $50. I paid him, picked up my hat, and left.
Hello?
Boss left with me. I was in the Black Garter last night. I was at the bar doing a kind of card games when the boss was through. We left together.
You didn't hear the shooting?
Yeah, nothing about it. You just tell us, Marshal. Ain't that so, boss?
That's it, Marshal.
Say, who's running the law office in Dodge? You or young rannies like this Cumler and his part?
That's enough, Pelkey. Don't ride that trail. Now, look, Marshal, if it'll help, I'll get Pelkey to write out a sworn statement about our movements last night. And I can have one of my other riders witness it as truth, too.
You didn't say anything about him.
No, Pelkey and I picked him up straight after he left the Black Garter. He'd ridden in to see his gal, Jeannie Williams. One of the dancers, her night up, you know.
All right. Well, let's have the statement punishment, eh?
Sure. Anything to help the law. Ain't that so, Pelkey?
If I was toting the law badge, you wouldn't stand any sorry like this to nobody. I just cut him down.
Well, these fresh young frontier rennies have to be handled carefully. That's my word.
Marshal, ain't there a charge I can bring against Cumler and his bunch? Such as false accusation or something like that? I mean, he is now recalling me a murderer and a rustler.
Yeah, we're getting too soft these days, boss. Why don't we buckle on our guns and go right after this Cumler and his rannies, eh? Treat them to a dose of hot lead. Them galoots cause more trouble than they would.
There'll be no trouble of that kind, Pelkey. Try it and you'll be dealing direct with me.
What makes you figure that it's nothing, Marshal?
Hey, Pelkey, you want me to pin your ears back?
Just take it easy, fella, that's all.
You want to scare you none, Marshal?
You scare me?
Don't I scare you none like them rannies got you scared?
Why, you dumb critter.
Now, look, Sweeney, let's just get the statement fixed and I'll ride back to Dodge.
Huh? Sure. Come on, Pelkey. On your feet. On your feet.
It's going to cost you plenty, boss. Cost you plenty.
Don't take no notice of him, Marshal. Let's go inside and get some riding paper and things.
By the way, Sweeney, while I'm here, one other thing.
Yeah?
I think you've been stocking up this place a lot, huh?
Why, sure.
Fine calves, Peter.
That's right.
Let's have a look at your bills of sale, eh?
Bills of sale?
Yeah, well, if you bought calves and breeders, you got papers, receipts showing the name of the seller, how much, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Boss, here, let me...
Button up, Pelkey.
Yeah, but...
Go rustle up Tex Whitey. He's the other writer with us last night. One who visits Honey. All right, Tucker, you heard me. Scatter. Go on.
Sure.
Seems like you're well and truly in debt.
Debt?
Mine. Now, what would happen if I didn't give you a statement?
Sure, I knew you're dead.
This Commoner and his guards, they sure are stubborn. Not accepting your word, demanding proof. Don't that make you a sort of liar, Leroy?
A statement, bills of sale, that's all I need.
Yeah, what do you reckon I'm searching for?
Well, doggone it, I could have sworn I had them all neat and tidy someplace. And where's your office, Sweeney? Don't you have one?
Nope, not got around to fixing one yet. Mm. Say, look, Ed, take a look through them bundles, will you? Maybe they got shuffled there.
Uh-huh.
Oh, you dropped some, Marshal.
Oh, sure.
Hey, Tucky, we got work to do. Tell why you need him, too. Both of you, pronto.
That's when my brum tossed me. The last thing I recollect is the ground coming up and hitting me in the face. So now the last thing I recollect is the floor coming up and hitting me. I don't feel nor hear Sweeney, Pelkey, and the other hombre pick me up, carry me out to a barn, tie me good and tight with rope, and use my own bandana as a mouth gag. Nor do I hear the three of them fork leather from AAA. What I do feel is a gigantic throb in my head, a burning agony in my arms and legs with the ropes cut off circulation. And what I hear is myself behind the gag, calling myself for all the galoots this side of tarnation. Well, I started to struggle hard against the rope and quit fast. Now, calm down. Take a close look around. Sight against the far wall, an empty bottle lying on the ground. I copy the arch and movement of a snake. Reach the bottle with my feet. Lift the... bring the spurs down hard.
Inside the barn, boys. There's someone inside the barn. All right. Come on out, reaching for the clouds. If you don't come out, then we'll set this barn on fire.
I try yelling, but I make hardly a throat rustle. So I don't wait to use the broken bottle and the rope. I start arching again, only this time towards the barn door.
We're going to count three. If you ain't showing yourself by then, we start roasting you, no good coyote.
I reach the door, twist around, bend my knees, kick at the door. The door busts out. And there's Cumber and his pards goggle-eyed.
Say... it's Matt Morgan. All right, you fellas, get them ropes off there. Get them off.
They cut the ropes. I spit out the bandana. I tell them what happened. One of the men with Cumber locates my bronc. Rustle up my guns with a belt. Start casting around, looking for Sweeney's trail. Shower of rain falls just before Sweeney and his two gun folks ride off, so it's enough to leave the tracks of the three horses plain for us to follow.
Well, now, Morgan, I reckon as they're busy hustling them calves and cows alone, they won't hear us till we're right on them.
Not unless one of them looks around and spots them.
Come on, the scene is right. Straight at them, fellows. Come on. Hey,
Morgan, I guess we've been right stubborn.
I have, Cumber. Because Sweeney saved my life, I let my attitude get warped.
Well, anyway, Sweeney confessed to both the killing and the rustling, so...
Yeah, he confessed. Like I confessed, I was wrong.
Well, Dick, maybe we was all wrong. Who isn't once in a while? Anyway, what I want to say is, well, the critter who said two wrongs don't make a right was plumb loco. I was wrong, you was wrong. That's two wrongs. But now... shake, Marshal Morgan.
Join us again next week as Matt Morgan fights to bring law and order out of the wild violence of the West End, Gunsmoke. Gunsmoke is written by Ronald Ingleby and produced by Jim Bradley for R. Transom.